Hi Stefan Milo, you are an unrecognized genius, and or at the right place at the right time. Most probably a bit of both. With the help of the presence and publications of Arev Pelinsuma and Leonardo Nmerzi, you just started to squeeze standard dogma. It is you together with them who is putting a ceiling on out of Africa, this possibly without many others immediately noticing. As far as we know, you were able to achieve what no scientist ever publicly achieved. Stefan Milo, please keep the ball rolling. Please, you all commentators, keep Stefan's, and your, ball rolling, and he together with Arev Pelinsuma and Leonardo Nmerzi, will rewrite as very first the whole human history, as said, this together with Arev and Leonardo and still others, this right here and right now. Most of you probably have no idea how unique this is, and if you do not do it now, others will take that ball, and roll that ball into human history. And if you think this is untrue, and will not roll the ball, then we of At Origin for Existence will try to do so, probably together with other partners. In fact, we have been trying to get this ball rolling for years now, but we do not have the needed platform and or public, to get the needed support for this unique and historical effort and achievement, as you Stefan Milo especially with your guests and public, have. Consensus as well as the general public. And that includes most of you. Suppose that we modern humans are the result of interbreeding with Neanderthals, because we are told so by standard dogma for over 100 years, and you Stefan Milo, supposedly as a low-key detective, had at least one of your guest scientists. Arev Pelinsuma, in your video declare, this at 25:54 in your video that we are here reacting at, that these ancient individuals, the result or descendants from an expansion event that took place roughly 47,000 years ago, which supposedly carry a fraction of Neanderthal DNA of one group or gene pool of Neanderthals, did not leave any ancestry, which clearly indicates that there was no continuation of Neanderthal gene flow, and consequently also no descendants from Neanderthals. No descendants from Neanderthals means the collapse of out of Africa, simply because sub-Saharan Africans, which are out of Africa supposed ancestors, knowingly never presented Neanderthal DNA, but all modern humans did present and still present Neanderthal DNA. No out of Africa means that what the DNA-based ancestral markers point out all along, and in fact always was the obvious, and now also is our only ancestors left, and that are the Native Americans from an out of Americas. Genetics point out that the supposed out of Africans were still in one group when they met one group of Neanderthals, formed modern humans and then spread to all parts of the world. It must have been from one group of Neanderthals, because, according to your guest scientists, the Neanderthal DNA in modern humans points out exactly that. So, genetics squeezed our ancestors' possibilities down, and tell us that our ancestors were not in Africa anymore when they interbred with Neanderthals, and that only after interbreeding over and over, they got modern human DNA and then identical modern humans spread to all continents, except to sub-Saharan Africa. Native Americans have different DNA, as well as higher frequencies of Neanderthal and of Denisovan DNA, and consequently the out of Africa, plus interbreeding with Neanderthal hypothesis falls apart, because of at least one essential paradigm and or the improbability. The migration out of Africa recently is proven to have occurred around 47,000 years ago. Next, the interbreeding should need to unfold, and that would take several generations. Next, the resulting modern humans are supposed, amongst others, to have migrated to Indonesia and Australia, where evidence of modern humans is found over 10,000 years before 47,000 years ago. This again is impossible, so we have a second essential paradigm, and or the improbability gets confirmed once more. What the ancestral markers point out. Let us this time follow what the ancestral markers point out. That is that we descend from ancient Native Americans, or ancient inhabitants of the Americas if you prefer. Native Americans are the only ones that presented individuals with high Denisovan as well as Neanderthal DNA and individuals with the markers of Africans, so not any further interbreeding is needed and the spreading has no time restriction and no ceiling. There is no need for improbable interbreeding with archaics. There is no need for humans the improbable passing of a land bridge with hundreds of kilometers of permafrost on both sides. No paradigms and no improbabilities. What also becomes more obvious for all, as well as confirmed, is the existence of an extended Austronesian expansion that makes good use of the strong and sustained Pacific currents to bring waves of ancient Native Americans to Oceania, that includes Polynesia, including the population Y, that represents hybrid descendants of Lucy-likes and of Lucia-likes, were more and less hybridized Native Americans, are the first or amongst the first inhabitants of Polynesia. Lucy is an early Australopithecine and is dated to about 3.2 million years ago. Lucia, a Paleo-Indian woman skeleton found in Brazil, had revealed that her genetic makeup is consistent with the ancestors of modern Amerindians. Out of Americas means that we, 8 billion modern humans, are descendants, or the actually living distant children, of ancient Native Americans. Some of the most important ancestral markers point to the Amazon forest and to the Amazon forest Amerindians. So we 8 billion modern humans are the distant children of Amazon forest Amerindians that once in a deep past built, this together with seed-dispersing animals like macaw, tapir, and many other animals, the Amazon forest with its fertile Amazon dark soils that are proof of our ancestors' and distant parents' kind of sacred work, together with animals that they still consider essential and sacred. Still today, the Amazon forest Amerindians in the Amazon forest, with its Amazon dark soils, consider their work and lifestyle as essential for preserving the Amazon forest, as well as ancestral and sacred.